Hi, welcome to the statics tutorials. So with this problem, we have a rigid body that's supported by a smooth frictionless pin at A and a smooth frictionless roller at B. It has a 120 kilonewton meter couple moment that's acting in the clockwise direction. It has a 10 kilonewton per meter distributed load over here. It's a rectangular shaped distributed load. And then we have a 50 kilonewton concentrated force that acts at this end B that's at a 30 degree angle. So let's draw our free body diagram. Remember, anytime you solve one of these equilibrium problems with rigid bodies or particles, you have to draw your free body diagram. So here's our shape of our free body. And then at A, thinking through this, this pin prevents us moving it in the X direction. So we have an AX as a reaction. This pin prevents us moving the bar up, so we have an AY as a reaction. But this pin doesn't prevent any rotation around A, and so there's no reaction moment at A. We have the 120 kilonewton meter couple moment. We have the 10 kilonewton per meter applied distributed load. We have the 50 kilonewton concentrated applied force. And then at B, we have this roller. This roller is only going to prevent us from pushing the beam down into the floor. So we have a single BY that acts only in the positive Y direction. Now we can do our sum of forces. So we do our sum of forces in the X. All we have is AX and then the X component of the 50 kilonewton force. So AX plus 50 kilonewtons cosine of 30. Solving for this, we get AX is equal to negative 43.3 kilonewtons. Oops. And we can do our sum of forces in Y. We get our negative 10 kilonewton per meter for our distributed load. Since that's a rectangular load, the area under is just going to be the base, which is our 2 meters times the height, which is our 10 kilonewton per meter. So there's our 10 kilonewton per meter times our 2 meters. Our AY from the reaction there, the Y component of the 50 kilonewton force, and then plus BY. We can't solve this equation directly because we have two unknowns, AY and BY, so we'll do a sum of the moments. When we do sum of the moments, we want to try to pick a location that has two unknowns through it, or maybe two variables through it. So in this case, we can pick A, and we can eliminate AX and AY out of our sum of the moments equations. So here we have sum of the moments at A. AX and AY go through A. They can't create a moment about A. Then we have the negative 120 kilonewton meter moment. It's negative because it's clockwise. It's already in moment units, kilonewtons times meters. It doesn't need to be multiplied by anything. Then we have our distributed load. And we have to do two things. We have to get the force from our distributed load, so 10 kilonewton per meter times 2 meters. Then we need to multiply by the distance back to A. So looking over here in our original diagram, it's 2 meters out to the distributed load. And then since it's a rectangle, it's going to be half of the way over to the centroid. So it's going to be 2 meters plus 2 meters divided by 2. And that's going to be our distance for our moment. Now it's going to give us a negative moment about A. Then we have the moment created by the Y part of our 50 kilonewton applied force, so 50 kilonewtons times sine of 30 degrees times 4 meters. And then we have the moment created by BY, so BY times 4. The only unknown that we have in this equation is BY, so we can solve for BY. And then we just plug BY back into our sum of forces in the Y equation. And we get AY is negative 25 kilonewtons. So we have our AX here, our BY there, and then our AY here. The negative sign on the AY just means that AY is pointing down instead of pointing up. Thanks for watching.